Lively with Sports Illustrated Kids. And Caleb, I just had a question for you. So all three tournament games, you've scored 30 or more points throughout all of the games so far. What do you think has attributed to your success in these pressure March Madness games so far?
He didn't score 30 in the game, but go ahead and talk about tonight's game.
Oh, well, tonight's game, you know, it was a must-win, you know, to the game to get to the Elite Eight. And, you know, I'm just proud of our guys. You know, my teammates is wonderful, and our coaching staff is the best in the country. So they put us in position to win, and that's what we did.
Right here.
Austin Petalo, Trend the Philly Hoops. Caleb, when you're out there and you're cooking the way you are, what's going through your head?
Just confidence level. Never lose my confidence level. You know, Coach Davis and my teammates always tell me that. I feel like that's the best part of my game is not to lose my confidence level. And when I'm out there, I'm just in a mode, and that's what that was tonight.
Ross Martin, Inside Carolina. Caleb, you changed shoes at halftime, and you obviously scored 27 in the half. What was that about, and what felt different in the second half?
Hoots told me to change because I never played good in a black shoe, so he told me to change them, and it worked out.
C.L. Brown, Raleigh News and Observer. Armando, this is for you and Brady, too. You guys were able to get second-chance baskets in the first half when maybe it seemed like the offense wasn't really coming along, that it wasn't in sync. How do you attribute what you were able to do on the boards? Was it the way they were playing defense, or was it just being aggressive?
Yeah, I mean, teams, they can, and myself too. I mean, if I'm not hitting shots or not doing anything, I can always, you know, rely on the offensive boards to find a way to draw fouls on the team, get easy putbacks. And, I mean, that's just what I kind of try to pride myself on and work real hard at.
Yeah, Henry Bushnell from Yahoo Sports right here. For all the players or anybody who wants to answer, I know you guys have been asked a bit about just the turnaround and some of the losses earlier in the season, specifically that Wake Forest game.
That was a long time ago. I apologize. No, I'm serious. You know, I mean, we've won now, 15 out of the last 18 games? I mean, that Wake Forest game was in January. As I told you before, I apologize. I'm a positive guy. I'm a positive guy. And these guys have won, 9 out of the last 10, 15 out of the last 18, and we're going to talk about a game in January?
Well, that's what I was going to ask.
Yeah.
What else about it, whether maybe it's his positivity or what else about it allowed you guys to go on this run?
I mean, our confidence never wavered. I mean, we knew even back then that we were this good of a team, and we knew that if we played at a high level and just really bought into everything. I mean, we knew we could make it this far. And Coach Davis and all the coaches, even when we struggled, always told us that. And, I mean, we never thought at one point we were a bad team.
Andrew Jones, Tar Heel Illustrated. For Brady, and if Coach could comment on this, I'd appreciate that as well. You were quite frustrated out there for a while in the second half, even ripped your headband off at one point. But you hit that three. I think Coach was trying to calm you down a little bit, but you hit that three. How big a shot was that for you? And how frustrated were you before that? And, Coach, I think you know what I'm talking about. You pulled him out because of the frustration. And then how big was that three that he hit?
Yeah, it was one of those games. Started off hot early. But, you know, these guys, they kept me up. They kept throwing me the ball, trusting me to shoot it. I mean, you got guys like Caleb playing unbelievable today. And Armando with that offensive rebound at the end. RJ with a big, big shot there in the paint. And Leaky with just a unbelievable night on defense. I mean, it doesn't all come down to me making shots, but I had an off night, and all these guys helped pull through.
Steve.
Guys, hi. Steve Politi from NJ.com. I'm just curious if you got to see the end of the St. Peter's game before you went on the court, and just your thoughts on playing a team that, you know, has kind of become America's darling as a 15 seed.
Can we talk about them tomorrow? They didn't see the end of it.
Okay, let's take next question.
Cole Nowak, Philly Sports Digest. My question is for Armando. The whole, basically the second half is very scrappy, a little bit towards the end. You kind of tussle for the ball real quick. But that final stretch, that minute when you had that huge block at the end and then that offensive rebound, can you kind of walk me through what you were thinking and how good did it feel to get that offensive put back and kind of put it to rest there?
Yeah, I mean, in the timeout, in the under 4 minute timeout, Coach Davis just told us to give our all. And, I mean, none of us wanted to go home, and we knew it was a great opportunity ahead of us. So, I mean, it was, I was just going all out, just trying to affect the game in as many ways as possible. And luckily, I mean, it was positive, and we ended up hitting a big shot and getting a few stops and rebounds. And I mean, I'm happy with the results.
Go ahead and back.
Terrence Hatchett, Carolina Blitz. And this is for anybody that wants to answer. You guys only scored 28 points in the first half and then scored 45 points in the second half. Is it safe to say that you guys played your brand of basketball in the second half versus the first half?
I mean, things weren't going offensively in the first half for us, and Coach Davis told us, you know, we still in this, and you know, to stay with it. You know, shots weren't falling. We were getting great shots, and we just weren't hitting them. And so Coach Davis told us keep our confidence up and keep shooting, getting great shots, and that's what we did.
Yeah, to piggyback on what Caleb said, you know, coming into halftime, Coach Davis told us, you know, we're fine, we're in a great spot, great shape. There's nothing to hold our heads down for. And, you know, coming to the second half, we wanted to, you know, make your first statement. And we wanted to play our brand of basketball, and that's what we did.
Trayvon Miles, ABC 11 Rally. RJ's question is for you. Knowing how good UCLA is defensively, how tough, or maybe it wasn't for you, was it to for you to stay patient and kind of run the offense the way you guys wanted to run it?
I mean, UCLA is a great team, great defensive team. You know, we had set plays that were able to pick apart the defense and get the mismatches we wanted. I think, you know, I did a good job of finding open teammates, and I knew when Caleb was hot, just have him keep him going. And I told him keep going. I gave him the ball at one point, and then he just hit like four in a row, I think it was. So, you know, it was a great win.
Adam Smith, Burlington Times News. Caleb, was there a shot early in the second half or a moment early in the second half that felt different, that maybe got you going or made you think you could turn it around? Because I think you're 1-for-8 in the first half and maybe 2-for-10 at one point early in the second half. Was there a moment like that, or did you feel anything start to change?
Yeah, Coach Davis just wanted me to attack the basket. He feels that I'm best, and I'm with him when I'm best going downhill. And so I got a few layups going, you know, getting downhill, and then the outside shot started to fall. So, you know, once you get those, see them go through, your rhythm is there.
Okay, we'll take two more for the student athletes here and then one in the back.
Jerome Taylor, City of Basketball Love. So this is questions for anyone but Caleb. When Caleb is going for 27 in the second half, what's going through anybody's mind? You know, what were you guys thinking?
I mean, my main focus was really just trying to set good screens and getting them open and trying to get the switch on the big, and then just being weak side. So, I mean, if they drove, I knew he would get it to me or try to get the rebound if he missed a shot. But, I mean, I think for all of us, we just trying to get out of his way and just let him work.
Okay, final one for the student athletes.
Armando David Teal with the Richmond Times-Dispatch. One of the few shots Caleb missed in the second half was the one where you go falling out of bounds and fling it back toward half court to him. Did you see him, or was that just a play where your instincts take over and you're just trying to save it?
Yeah, I mean, I think my instincts just took over. I mean, that was a pivotal moment in the game. I think it was maybe down three or something like that, and, I mean, we missed that shot. I mean, I don't know what would happen if I didn't get that board, and I just was trying to really just keep the play alive and just hopefully just threw the ball up, hoping that somebody would get it. And, I mean, it was great that Caleb had the instincts to find the ball and then to hit a big three after finding that. It was huge.
Do you have any more a question for Leaky? Right here.
Leaky, you guys did a pretty good job on them on defensive end. What kind of led to that success there? Like, what did you guys do well?
You know, just played our principles. You know, Coach Davis has a, you know, a game plan on a defensive end, and it was just, we just had to follow it. First half, they were hitting some tough shots. You know, we were there, and they just eventually in the second half just started missing them. So, I mean, that's pretty much it.
Gentlemen, thank you very much. Congratulations.
As they're leaving, two quick notes. 129 all-time NCAA tournament wins, that ties Kentucky now with the all-time record. And we've never had in the NCAA tournament play consecutive games where different players scored 30 points. Last game, RJ, this game.
Okay, questions for Coach Davis. Go ahead. Who has the microphone?
Cole Nowak, Philly Sports Digest. Coach, can you kind of talk about your team's conditioning? It's not really normal that you see kind of working a five-man rotation through the entire game, and you take pride in having all your guys just completely be able to compete for the full 40 minutes?
Well, I don't go into a game thinking the starting five is going to play 40 minutes. It's dictated by, you know, what's going on in the game and how guys are playing. And I thought Dontrez came in and gave us really good 4 to 5 minutes. And I thought Puff came off the bench and gave us really good 10 minutes off the bench at different positions. And so I was really happy with the production from those two guys off the bench. And they really helped us get a little bit of rest for RJ, for Armando, and also Brady in the second half.
Awesome, Petalolo, trying to Philly hoops. Philly, or Hubert,
yeah.
When Caleb's doing all that in the second half and he's scoring it well, is there kind of a level of trust that you have with him that you're kind of like, okay, here, do whatever you want. I can trust you. Or are you kind of still running the offense and kind of designing stuff there?
No, I mean, we were running our offense, and we found matchups that we felt like that we can get good shots from. And, you know, Caleb is, because of his size and as an athleticism, he's the one guy, probably the best on the wing, that can create his own shot at any given time. The area that I thought he was really good tonight, and he talked about it, he started inside out. And at times where he gets trouble is when he starts outside in or outside, outside, outside. And he went inside in, and I just feel like he has the ability to attack the basket, and he was able to get to the rim. And I've always felt that way. Even for me, I wasn't as quick and as athletic, but I always wanted to get a couple layups. Then you feel better stepping out and shooting that jump shot. And I think because of his aggressiveness towards the basket, he found a rhythm out there beyond the three, and he just got hot.
I'm Anna Lively with Sports Illustrated Kids. Coach, can you just put into words what it means to you to make it to the Elite Eight in your first season as head coach of your alma mater?
You know, I really am not thinking about myself at all. I'm just really happy for them. The only thing that I've ever wanted is I want them to experience and see the things that I've been able to experience here at North Carolina as a player. And I've told them definitively in a number of times that's what I want from them. And so I feel like this year, where I feel happiness and joy and I'm proud, is that they're getting those memories. Like, these are things that they're going to be talking about for the rest of their life. And I get a chance, a front row seat, to be able to witness that. And so it's just not about me at all. This coaching is an act of service. It's about helping and coaching and teaching these kids on and off the court and just trying to help them out.
Over here. Go ahead.
Pat Walter, WRAL Sports. Hubert, talking about making memories, Caleb Love tonight. I think he said that you were the one that told him to switch shoes.
No, I didn't. I didn't even know he switched shoes.
So one of the other coaches did, I guess. Who's did? Okay.
Yeah.
So what
Director
did you think?
Of player personnel, I'm going to give him a raise. Because, you know, so just let Hoots know. I didn't even know he switched shoes. I don't think it was the shoes. I just think that Caleb played really well. And, you know, one of the things that I said is that, in any game, but specifically in big-time games like this, it has nothing to do about coaching. It's about players just stepping up and making plays. And everybody that played made plays, and Caleb made a lot, especially in the second half.
Jeremiah Holloway, Daily Tar Heel. Coach, over here, yeah. Coach, Brady talked about it a little bit, but, of course, the scoring went down a little bit in the second half, but, of course, he was active on the boards and also defensively. Can you talk about, like, you know, how much that impacted the outcome of tonight's game, even though offensively his scoring went down just a bit?
Anytime Brady's on the floor, he impacts the game. You know, he's more than a jump shooter. He's a basketball player. He can attack the offensive glass. He's a great rebounder. He's an excellent passer. He's an instinctive player. And when he's out there on the floor, you have to stay with him. So he gives us tremendous spacing on the offensive end. And he got a little frustrated in the second half because he missed a couple shots that he felt like he normally makes. And so we took him out and just gave him a little breather and just let him collect his thoughts. And then we put him back in and tried to make him laugh and tell him a couple jokes. And it loosened him up a little bit, and he was able to hit that three. And I'm just, for him, he's never been this far before. And for somebody that this is the first year he's ever lived anywhere outside of Oklahoma, and for him to trust me as my first year as head coach and be a part of this program and to do what he's doing and experiencing what he's experiencing, it's a pretty cool feeling. I'm just really, really happy for him.
Hubert, when Manek hit the three with four and change left, you seem to be more demonstrative and emphatic on the sideline. I saw you kind of give yourself a couple of less goes. When you got in the huddle, how did you how much confidence did you guys have that you were going to be able to close out strong in the way that you did?
Well, we've always, whether we're able to close out or not, we have great peace and confidence to be able to close out games because we've done that before. I mean, we did it twice against Louisville. We did it against Syracuse. We did it at Duke. We've done it at Baylor. We did it against Marquette. And so Virginia Tech a couple of times. And so we've been in those situations before, late clock, late situations where a play needs to be had. And we've always stepped up to the challenge, whether it's worked out for us or not. So in those situations, we grab and hold on to those past experiences, and it gives us confidence and it gives us peace.
Adam. Hubert, Adam Zagoria. Just wondering, did you ever come across Shaheen Holloway in coaching or scouting or anything? And what are your thoughts on, you know, what he's done with that program here this year?
You know, it's just unbelievable. It's just being able, you know, the thing that just jumps right out is how much his players love playing for him, and they have his personality. They have a chip on their shoulder and a toughness and a confidence to give everything that they have on both ends of the floor on every play. And they're here for a reason, because they're an incredible team, but they're also incredibly tied together. Tremendous chemistry. On Sunday, it'll be our toughest game of the year.
Thank you, Coach.